Hi and welcome to another moment with Mike and Lois.
Hi.
So we're talking about remaining confident.
Right.
And Hebrews talks about how we need to really retain our confidence,
yes.
Remain in our confidence.
Yes.
Because if we do, it will be richly rewarded.
Mm.
And I was thinking about how when God uses words that we use and have one idea of, we have to understand that when God uses them, He's talking from a completely different perspective. So when we say rich, we have an idea of what rich would be.
Mm.
When God says rich and richly rewarded, it's another dimension that it will bring rewards into our life that will surpass anything that we could ever think about.
Mm.
So that if we will retain that confidence, we will be richly rewarded. There will be rewards to our confidence that we can't even begin to imagine.
Yeah. Is it no wonder that that is exactly what the enemy is after?
Right.
He understands that the rewards come from keeping your confidence. So if he can grab hold of that and drag that away from you, then he can nullify your effectiveness.
Right.
So if the enemy can get us to doubt our worthiness, then he can attack our confidence.
Right.
As we were talking about God's love yesterday and how often we don't feel worthy of God's love. Well, if he can take away the thoughts of our worthiness towards God's love, then he can attack our confidence and then he'll steal our reward.
Right.
And that's what he's after, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because we know that he's out to steal, kill and destroy. That's the very thing that he's after. He's there to steal, kill and destroy our confidence. If he can whip that away from underneath our feet, he's basically got us.
Because everything flows from that relationship with God.
Yeah.
Everything flows from the love of God. The reason that the love of God is taught so much about and why Jesus taught so much about it, especially just before he was crucified to really prepare the people around him, was because so much flows out of that love.
Yeah.
The power of God flows out of that love.
Yeah.
Like you said yesterday, if we don't have that relationship with God, it's no good being gifted because our gift is not going to see us through.
Not going to cut the mustard.
No, absolutely.
No.
And so really we have to understand that what the enemy is trying to do is to kind of take away our confidence to the point where the power that's in us that can't go anywhere else, it's in us, lies dormant.
Yeah.
So in other words, it's true that God doesn't ever leave us.
No.
So that power never leaves us.
No, it's always there.
But we leave it because we leave it dormant.
Yeah. Yeah. And how much are we missing out on? How much is the world missing out on simply because the power inside of us is lying dormant?
Right. Yeah.
That needs to be activated.
And I think the enemy knows only too well that if we can be in a position where he puts us, where he steals that confidence, he will basically not only allow that power to lie dormant, but it will stop things in our lives.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not just like it's a power that we just use like a superpower just to bring it out, you know. We need that power on a daily basis to be able to break through.
Yeah.
So I think when we accept that there's nothing that can separate us or invalidate God's love, we realize that there's nothing that can void his power.
Yeah.
Which is powerful.
Yeah, it is. It's getting our head around that.
Yeah.
We are not worthy, we've been made worthy.
Right.
So there's nothing in us that makes us worthy. So therefore it's already out of your hands, so you don't have to worry about that. You've been made worthy to the blood of Christ. So therefore, once you've got that and you start to build your confidence on that, that underpins everything else in your life. That's the foundation then on which you can actually use God's power in every area of your life.
Yeah, the power flows out of the love.
Yeah.
You know, that's why it's called the power of love. It's true. The power is contained in the relationship, in the love of God.
Yeah.
Well, we're going to leave it there for today, but we'll talk a little bit more about that and how we need that power in our lives tomorrow. But whatever you're doing today, know that you are loved, and within that love is a power to be able to overcome any situation today. Whatever you're doing, have a great day.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.